What's up, everybody? So in this video, I'm going to be going over my Sunday thoughts of the market for crypto. So every Sunday, I'm going to be going over my entire view on the crypto market, kind of how we're going, key levels to watch out for, and some trade ideas that I'm considering taking it with my portfolio and how I'm looking to structure my portfolio over the next, coming months as we do enter what I think is going to be pristine buying opportunity, because I think that, ultimately a recession is coming in the US and we are going to experience some sort of volatility to the downside to then take advantage of. I also genuinely think that there's a chance that Binance, the world's largest exchange that owns 50% of the liquidity, goes under. And I know that's a really hot take in crypto, but if and when that does happen, that aligns with the recession narrative that's coming and, peak tops that we're seeing within the market for this traditional market. Things could line up. So anyways, let's get into the video. Before I get into the charts, please make sure to like and subscribe. My name is Dennis, and this is my YouTube channel. We're going to go through the total market cap first. I'm going to clean this chart up and walk you guys through how I'm kind of seeing the market right now and things to just watch out for. So this is the total market cap. So this is total one, total crypto market cap. First of all, this looks like a genuine accumulation range, a high time frame accumulation range that we're forming. You have your range high. Why isn't it working? You have your range high. Okay, here we go. Let's make sure that's locked. Range high, range low, and roughly, I always like to have a fib out for this. Roughly your mid-range right around here, right? And look where price action is bouncing right now, basically, or it has bounced already off of, right off the mid-range. So for me, if I'm looking at the total, a lot of people are getting really bullish here. And for sure, there's a chance that price action can come up all the way up here to this 1.32 trillion level. However, I think that is, not nearly as likely. But anytime we've gotten up here, we had a big sell-off, couldn't even get up, came down, retraced, made this nice bottom, double bottom, bounced up, came up to the $1.2 trillion level, rejected, tried it again, rejected, and now it seems like we might try to get back up. Stochastic RSI, curling to the upside, which is relatively bullish for a high time frame level. The three-day time frame, chilling, getting up to those oversold levels. And then if we zoom into the daily time frame, we're already up here. So to me, this tells me if I were to, take another range within a range, we're basically sitting at this high, right? So to me, this is how I would draw this. I want to see price action come out of this range that we're stuck in. You zoom into the 4 hour, it seems like we're already beginning to get trouble, right? I don't think I drew that right.
So this guy has to be right on top right here, boom, just like that.
So this is exactly how I would view it. And look, price action, well, that's weird. Okay, so price action is getting really close to tagging this level. And to me, that just says like, if it's indeed a range, which it seems like it is, anytime we come down here to the low, we get tagged, we get deviation, come up, right? Who's to say we don't just do something like this, come back inside, short, and then the whole market goes under, right? So that's total market cap drawn up pretty quickly. If we manage to get above the $1.1 trillion level, there's a good chance that we come up and take out all these stops up here, right? So if I'm a trend line drawer, how I would basically do it is this, right? Here's my one trend line, and then here's another one, right? So here's another way you can look at the chart pretty quickly, right? So you're like, oh, price action should come up here, which aligns with all this liquidity, right? All these wicks that have been built up right around here. We might even revisit, these highs and take these highs up here. Everyone's going to be super bullish. Everyone's going to get super bullish in the beginning of October because of this. And to me, this is just eyes for concern. Also, if I were to zoom out, look at the stochastic RSI, the oscillator, at the highs as well, right? So let me just actually, I want this mid-range here. Let me just remove this really quickly. One thing I want to point out as well, look at every time we've gotten to these highs, right? right? Boom. Just draw some vertical lines. Vertical lines, boom. And we're at the same level, right? So to me, this is just something to keep an eye out for, right? Doesn't mean that it has to happen again, but if you're assuming that we are at the later stages of a bear market, so we are relatively around this level here in the market, what are the odds that we experience something like this before price action really just goes parabolic over for the next, you know, the next bull cycle, right? Price action typically is fractal. So I could see something like this playing out, right? Obviously the high would be a little higher, I would hope. But again, interested to buying in the lower half of the range, you know, when you think about it like this. So to me, I'm not really bullish. Everyone's super bullish. And obviously there's a ton of green on my chart and I am currently in a long for SAMO, but I'm not interested at these levels. For Total 2, very similar situation. We seem like we're getting a breakout. We go to the weekly, same thing. We're testing this level. We're about to come up and test this mid-range. If we can get above this mid-range, and this mid-range is way more clear of a level to me, right? You have this low, which is extremely important, but then you have this really key high time frame mid-range that we are testing. If we can get above it, we'll, you know, likely come up and tag this high, in my opinion. So if I were to go to Bitcoin, levels that I want to watch out for, so this is the range that we're trapped on the daily time frame. If we come up above 28K, essentially 28,089, and deviate back inside, I think that's room for a short. Personally, every time we've come up on these levels, price action seems to just deny it. Plus, these moves seem to be a little inefficient as well, so that's something that I'm keeping my eye on. Solana, baby. Solana, my favorite coin. So I tweeted this. If you guys want to follow me on Twitter, link in the description below. This is my range for Solana on the daily time frame. To me, the daily time frame is basically saying, yeah, look, we have this key level monthly SR at 2392 that we have to stay above, because if I zoom out to the monthly time frame, you'll see that every time price action has gotten to the monthly, this monthly level, it's had trouble staying above it. Again, monthly stochastic RSI looking up, which is not something you'd want to see. Going back to the daily, if we can get a close here in the next 4 minutes, that could be really bullish. And we could come up and see these highs at 2680. However, it seems like if I zoom into the 4 hour, we're getting a slowing of momentum and we're getting some bearish divergence. So that's something that I want to keep an eye out for Solana. ETH Bitcoin, I always like to go through just because it's important to know, you know, where we are in the market. To me, this is, again, another range that we're stuck in, a high time frame range nonetheless, but and this is what it would look like. Maybe draw a little trend line for some confluence. Assuming we do get some bullishness because of where ETH BTC is, I could see us retest this trend line and then, you know, do something like this, get everyone bullish, come back down, and eventually, you know, a huge buying opportunity would be somewhere along these, you know, these lows, in my opinion. So one huge piece of note I want to talk about, this is market cap of USDC, right? One thing that I notice on the daily time frame, which again, this is in the market cap of USDC, there's a huge gap between 11 billion and 20 billion that could get filled. Price action usually likes to fill gaps. I don't know why, but it does. Although this chart is a little different because this is a market cap of a coin, of a stable coin. But again, look at this weekly stochastic RSI chilling up here. Anytime we've had a weekly move, we'll see a leg down, right? See some sort of red before another leg up. So just something to keep an eye on. But yeah, guys, so this is the video. Quickly going over some charts. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video. If you guys like the video, make sure to like and subscribe. My name is Dennis, and I will see you on the next one. See ya.